Philippine environment officials inspect a controversial resort built in Bohol's iconic Chocolate Hills. Local government officials also explain why the resort was allowed to operate despite a closure order from the Environment Department. Rafael Bosano reports.
Personnel from the Environment Department inspected on Thursday the controversial Captain's Peak Resort in Chocolate Hills in Sagbayan Municipality, Bohol. But members of the media were requested to remain outside the premises. After the inspection, the DNR personnel did not talk to media about their findings. Hours prior to the closure of the resort, its workers quietly worked, fixing and taking things out of a mini store that will be shut down. A worker admits she doesn't fully understand what is happening, only that by sunrise, she'll be jobless.
Hindi ko talaga maintindihan itong pamalaan. Ba't ganun? May nilabag daw kami. Sinira daw yung buntod. Hindi naman.
Captain's Peak Resort Manager Julieta Sablas says their establishment is more than just a place for recreation.
Parang ang sakit sa dibdib po. Wala po silang mindset na sana ganito, hindi na lang mapasira yung Captain's Peak Resort kasi kawawa naman yung mga taong nagtatrabaho dyan.
Aside from employees, there are no other people at the resort. An aerial view shows the resort situated in a valley between three hills. Some structures strikingly punctuate and distract the view of the lush hills, something that is not supposed to happen following conditions of a resolution passed by the Protected Area Management Bureau. Based on a 2018 resolution, among the conditions for the PAMB's endorsement of the resort is to ensure that structures blend with the natural environment of the Chocolate Hills, as well as securing that Vital Environment Compliance Certificate, or ECC. Sablas, however, admits it was something they overlooked because authorities allegedly did not demand it from them.
Yung nagbigay po sila ng clearance sa PAMB, doon sa baba, naka-state po yun na need to comply the ECC. Pero hindi namin nagawa ng paraan. Parang smooth lang, nag-ooperate kami. Alam nila kasing nag-ooperate na kami. Kung talagang yung the law, if ever you are not allowed to operate without that certificate, talagang i-stop nila kami.
With the exception of an ECC, Captain's Peak has complete documents from transfer certificate of title, DTI registrations, fire safety certificates, and a business permit issued last January. The local government says they will now be more strict in terms of scrutinizing documents.
There is a regular presumption on the part of the office of the mayor kasi nadadaan yan sa MPDC at sa engineering office at saka sa Mendro, pati sa assessor. I think we have to be more strict na make it sure that all the laws should be complied with.
Meanwhile, Bohol Governor Aris Aumentado is seeking a dialogue with the DNR and LGU and even mulling filing administrative cases against the agency. This after it allegedly failed to swiftly act on the matter. Like the municipal government of Sagbayan, they too only learned of the closure order through social media. Both houses of Congress are also set to launch their investigations. ACT-CIS party list representative Erwin Tulfo says they want to know who gave the green light for the resort's construction. UNESCO National Commission Secretary General Ivan Inagis urges the Department of Environment and Natural Resources and the local government of Bohol to look into possible violations in the construction of the resort.
My recommendation really is for the DNR and the local government at Bohol to sit down and discuss the situation, determine if there were violations, why this resort was allowed to build on the hills. I saw that there were some elements of the resort that damaged the hills themselves, and I think it was a violation. So the local government at Bohol and DNR, if indeed there were prior permits given, if you notice a violation to the resort, then the order is closure.
UNESCO declared Bohol Island as a global geopark last year, the only one in the country, because of its geological identity, which took hundreds of millions of years to form, including the Chocolate Hills. in August declined to answer if the construction of the resort will affect the status of Chocolate Hills as a UNESCO Global Geopark. The title was given to Chocolate Hills last year, and validation is done every 4 years. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News, Bohol.